there a God in heaven? Is there a God on earth? Is there any God at all? We might be surprised if we give some consideration. God defined as something we serve as special to a person's, to what a person believes. Truth. Think of truth. Does truth have a beginning? Does truth have an end? Before anything existed, wouldn't truth have to exist? And if everything ceased to exist, would it not be truth who caused it to cease to exist? Therefore, would truth still not exist? Truth has no beginning. Truth has no end. Truth is the designer, the creator of all things everywhere, in all of creation. Truth is not just what man discovers. If truth is to be discovered, then truth must exist. So eternal Father Truth, omnipotent and omnipresent, that means all-powerful, and present in everything, controlling everything, directing everything, building and tearing you down, always present. Always in control. Truth is a pretty awesome God. But what must be the spirit of truth? Well, do you not have to love something to create it? To maintain it? To let it continue to exist? Wouldn't unconditional love towards all and everything that submits to truth, that follows truth, wouldn't unconditional love have to be the spirit of truth? So now we have Father Truth, eternal Father Truth, his spirit, unconditional love. His Son? Is not His Son the form of God? The one and only ever begotten bodily, visible form in which God has always stood, revealing Himself manifest before His creation? Some people say, well, that's hard to believe, Ed. Well, consider this. Einstein's law of the conservation of energy states that energy cannot be destroyed. It can only change form. Well, we can readily admit that each and every one of us is energy, are we not? The very thoughts of the mind can be recorded on an oscilloscope and seen and observed on the graph, on the screen of that oscilloscope. And no two readings on an oscilloscope are the same. The readings that come from what the machine would detect coming from me are not the same readings that would come from you. And are they not recorded as electrical impulses? Are electrical impulses not energy? Can energy be destroyed? We're each and every one of us unique individuals. And as such, we are a unique, we each have a unique energy signature. And energy cannot be destroyed. It can only change form. The Bible speaks of heaven and hell, paradise and oblivion, the lake of fire. Well, the fire of God is the truth revealed according to Scripture. And a lake is a body of water, an enclosed body of water. It doesn't go anywhere. A lake of fire. A place where the worm does not die. That energy signature, that consciousness does not die. But there's no exit. It's where we understand, but there's no way out. We've already condemned ourselves because of godlessness. If we reject the idea of God, if we hear the gospel of Jesus Christ, and reject that, oblivion is our destiny, the lake of fire. Hell and paradise eludes us because we haven't loved God as God has loved us. Something to think about. We celebrate Christmas this year, 2023, and we say it's the day that we recall the birth of the Christ. Was the Christ not God Himself taking off His immortality? And putting on mortality. Everything that's mortal has to grow, it has to mature. Did Jesus not enter the body of that virgin? Come to birth? Did he not grow into maturity? And then reveal himself as the Christ, doing miracles no mere mortal can do, including rising from the dead. When people rejected him, accused him, arrested him. And crucified him unto death. But in fulfillment of what the word, the truth of the prophets had said would happen, he rose from the dead on the third day, no longer mortal, but returned to the Father, immortal once again. And now, truth and love dwelling in his people who acknowledge his identity and follow his instructions. His instructions are not hard. Love as God has loved his creation. creation exists. It continues to exist. His creation loves God. So the first and greatest command, love the Lord your God with all your mind, all your heart, all your soul, all your strength, and all your understanding. And love your neighbor as yourself. Don't do to anyone else. Don't even think anything about anyone else or say anything against anyone else or do anything against anyone else that you would not appreciate someone else thinking or doing or saying against you. As I said, it's Christmas. Wise men follow that star. The prophecy of the testimony. The testimony of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy. And the wise follow and save themselves by believing, acknowledging, calling upon the name of the Lord. Jesus is his name. Remember that this Christmas, this day of remembrance. It may not be the actual date that Jesus was born. It doesn't matter. It's the day we have chosen to celebrate this reality. Emmanuel. It means God himself with us. Isaiah 7:14. He's the first and he's the last. He's the living God. As the prophet said, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was, past tense, who is, present tense, and who is to come, future tense. Are you ready? Merry Christmas.